Hi students, have you ever travelled on a train? I'm sure most of us would have the experience of travelling on a train, and it's such a wonderful experience getting to know the nature very closely, the breeze and many things around you within the train and outside the train. Let me introduce you to the topic for the day, The Girl on the Train. A short story written by Ruskin Bond. This is prescribed for you under literature in and as identity. The Girl on the Train by Ruskin Bond. I'm sure most of us are quite familiar with Ruskin Bond. Let me give you a very brief description about Ruskin Bond. He's an Indian writer born to British parents in the year 1934. And he's best known for his contributions to children's literature. He's written over 500 short stories, and it is for these short stories that he won many awards, like the Sahitya Academy Award, Padma Sri Award and the Padma Bhushan. If you can look at his childhood, when he was 8 years old, his parents had a divorce and this affected him very badly. And at the age of 10, if we notice, his father, whom he was very attached to, passed away. And Ruskin Bond lived in India with his British parents, and mostly there his early childhood was in Shimla and in Gujarat. And when he was a child, he started reading. He was interested in books and he started writing in his late teens. And his first semi-autobiographical novel, The Roof on the Top. This is a semi-autobiographical novel. This was published in his late teens. And after which you see that he writes umpteen number of works and thus becomes a prolific writer. Most of his work, if you can read most of his works, you can see that it is all set in Dehradun, a beautiful town, or it's a beautiful hill station. And it captures the beauty of the Himalayan landscape. So most of the stories are set in Dehradun and it captures the beauty of the Himalayan landscape. So this is just a very brief description about him, his childhood and his writings. This particular work, which is prescribed for you, The Girl on the Train, was published in 1988 under the title The Eyes Have It. What a different title altogether. One, The Girl on the Train. So we do know that there is a girl, there is a train out here, and this is the reason as to why I asked you if you've ever traveled on a train. And look at the earlier title, The Eyes Have It. Nothing to do with the second title, isn't it? So we are assuming that there could be something to do with the eyes. So what about the eyes? Let's take a look at the story. This story, the entire setting of the story is on a train journey. You have only two characters out here. The blind man, unnamed man, who is the narrator. So this is a first person narrative. And it is this blind man who narrates the entire story, and a girl that he meets on his train journey while they move to Missouri. So here you can see the blind man and the girl meets on a train journey, and the blind man is on his way to Missouri. In between the journey, the girl gets in at a station named Rohana. Okay, so as we move on, we can see that this particular story, as I said, it is set on the train, and this is also a story which happens in the month of October. We will get to know why we say that this happens in the month of October. So as I've mentioned already, a girl who gets in at Rohana and the blind man who is sitting on the train, when they reach the station of Rohana, he can hear the voice of her parents who sees her off at this particular station. So they're giving her goodbyes, and this girl gets in. As soon as she gets in and as soon as she's settled, you can see that the blind man is pretending not to be blind or not to reveal his blindness to the girl who has just walked in. The blind man seems to be quite an interesting person. As soon as the girl gets in, he thinks to himself, "What a wonderful voice." Remember, he cannot see the girl. And he thinks to himself, "What a wonderful voice." And that is when he starts speaking to her. "Hi." The girl was taken in for a surprise because she did not realize that there was somebody in the same cabin as she was. Maybe she was too busy settling down and keeping her things. And then they have a very wonderful conversation. A very natural conversation, we would say, and a very small one though. So the blind man asks the girl, "Where are you off to?" And then she says, "I'm getting down at Sharanpur." That is yet another place which is mentioned. And the girl asks the same question to him, "Where are you getting off?" And he says, "I'm going to Missouri." And then she says, "Wow, what a wonderful place to be in, especially during the time of October." That is when we get to know that this train journey takes place in the month of October. And then you can see a very clear, vivid description about Missouri and how it feels during the month of May. They say that Missouri would be covered with dahlias in the hills. It's beautiful flowers. And then she also says that the sun is very bright. And then during the nights, you can just sit in front of a log fire. So this is a brief description about Missouri that you get during their conversation. And then the blind man asks the girl, "So you don't have a long journey?" And she says, "Yes, I would rather not have a long journey because I hate sitting on the trains more than 2 to 3 hours. And then he says, "You're soon going to get off." And then he's also, again, as I said, he's pretending not to be blind. And then he says, "How does it look out of the window? How does it look? How is this place?" And he feels that, you know, she would have identified his blindness, but not with the answer. The answer that she says, "Why don't you just look out of the window?" So again, he feels that he's played it quite well. She has not identified his blindness. So assuming to see something, he looks out of the window. And when he looks out of the window, he can only listen to the sounds that he hears. And then she asks, "I can see animals." And he was sure that in the place of Dera, there are not many animals found nearby. But since he wasn't too sure of, and since he was blind, he just did not answer to it at all. And then the train arrives at the station at Sharanpur here. You can see that the girl says bye, goodbye to this blind man. And when the girl comes and stands very close to this blind man, again he can get a very beautiful smell, a very good smell of her hair. And then he wonders, could it be short? Could it be a long hair? He hasn't any eyes. And therefore he's wondering as to how it could be, because he's not perceived the world. So this is his perception. How could it be? She gets off at the station. Again, the blind man can hear some commotion out there. And then you can see that another passenger comes in and sits right next to him. And then this new passenger says, I'm sorry, I wouldn't be as interesting as the passenger that you just had. And the blind man, very eager to know about this girl, asks him, didn't she have a pretty face? And the new passenger says, well, I don't know if she had a beautiful face or a pretty face, but it was her eyes that kept me looking at her. And then he says, oh, wow, then she definitely must be very pretty and a very beautiful girl. And then the new passenger says, well, the eyes have it all. It's all in the beauty of her eyes. But these eyes are of no use to her. She is blind. Didn't you notice? How ironical a story. Look at how Ruskin Bond brings about a situational irony. Did we ever think of the girl to be blind? Wasn't she also playing a game just like the blind man? She never wanted to reveal her blindness. Neither did he want to reveal his blindness. How they perceive the world. We all have eyes. But don't we pretend a little too much? Do we really see with our eyes? Or do we only see the things that are shiny in front of us? Do we really look into the intricate details of the things around us? Do we stop and observe? Shouldn't we be doing that? So Ruskin Bond has beautifully portrayed the situational irony, where the events in the story turn out contrary to the reader's expectation. Definitely the readers were not thinking of a blind girl, and that is why we say that the events were contrary to the reader's expectation. It is only at the end, or the very last line of the story, a very small story, but it's only at the end or the last line of the story we get to know that the girl is blind. The girl is blind. And therefore, we can see that the readers did not expect it at all. One of the major themes in this novel is kindness. You can see that the blind man was very kind to this girl who stepped in. Though he was pretending to be not to be blind, you can see that he was very kind to the girl. He wanted to have a conversation with the girl. He wanted to know how it would be for the people who was able to see, thinking that she was also a person who had eyes and who was able to see the world, without even realizing the fact that she is also blind. So you can see that there is a lot of kindness in this story. Are we kind to others? Something that we need to be pondering about. Then, as I've already mentioned here, contrary to the reader's expectation, situational irony, and therefore we can also say that there is a tricky narration here. A very tricky narration. That was how wonderful Ruskin Bond was. He really knew how to get into the children. And that is why I said he is a man known for his writings to do with children's literature. And the story is very brief, with intricate details. It's about how we perceive things, how blind perceive things, and how the world is to them. And then you can also see about human perception. How is it that we perceive things around us? As I've already mentioned, this is something that we really need to look into, really need to work upon. Do we really observe the things around us? José Saramago. In his novel, Blindness, tells us about this human perception. If you've not read this, if you feel interested, if you find it interesting, I would suggest that you also read this novel, at least go through the summary of this novel, Blindness. And he says, if you can see, look, and observe. Do we really wait to look? Do we really observe things? Or are we blind to everything around us? This is something that we need to look upon. I hope you've understood the story by Ruskin Bond. I'll just give you a recap. The girl on the train, there are only two characters out here, both unnamed, a blind man who is introduced to us in the beginning, and then a girl who starts off the journey with him, and the entire story is set on a train journey. They are on their way to Missouri. This girl gets in from Rohana, and she is getting off at the station Sharanpur. And then you can see that there is a very brief conversation between them. And it's only at the end of the novel, with this minute character out here, or the third character out here, who is also important, because it's only through this character that we get to know that the girl is also blind. And that puts the blind man into a total silence. Thank you, and please read through the story, and we'll meet you in the next class. Thank you.